A Braskem entrevista a psicóloga canadense Susan Pinker. Com mais de 25 anos de experiência e autora de 2 livros, seu trabalho de pesquisa busca entender a mente humana no contexto da evolução. No mundo moderno e veloz, estamos perdendo a capacidade de nos relacionarmos com outras pessoas ou a tecnologia é uma grande influenciadora disso?
Social interaction is a skill like any other skill. It's like learning higher algebra or parking your car in a tight spot. You need to practice to get better and better at it. And some people are naturally better at it and some people naturally struggle more. However, it is the beginnings of social interaction are there in every newborn baby. And for example, every newborn baby focuses on their mother's face first and on human faces first and on objects second. So I would say that we're not losing it completely, but we're getting hoodwinked into thinking that we don't need it as much as we do and that it can be supplanted by digital technology completely. And I think the difference is that information can be transmitted through digital media, but nonverbal communication cannot be. And I'll give you an example. I was once in an airport lounge where a man was having a very passionate discussion with his girlfriend on his iPad. And then they called the flight and he picked up the iPad and he kissed the glass of the iPad. It was his girlfriend or his wife. And this was even at the beginning of tablet technology, and it dawned on me as he thinks that's good enough, right? Or close to the real thing. And of course, that's, you know, a kiss is not a kiss if it's through an iPad. Technology is not entirely to blame. If we blame technology completely, that's scapegoating new technology. I think it's partially to blame. I think there are other factors. I think as we societies get richer, there's much more mobility. So for example, children grow up and move far from home, and so parents age are more likely to age by themselves. That's less to do with technology than with opportunity, for example. It's just the downside of opportunity. More successful societies offer give you the opportunity to live alone if that's what you choose, instead of living in a huge extended family or with a lot of roommates, where financially, if you were pinched, you'd have to do that. But paradoxically, people who live alone, we now know, have a lifespan that's 30% shorter than people who have forced interaction through living in a social environment. Digital technology has pushed us away from each other in that way, so that people who work together are actually no longer in the same physical space anymore. And even if they are, they communicate digitally and not in person. And the same goes for families, where many families are having dinner with all their smartphones on the table, communicating with other people. I'm sure you've had the experience of being in a restaurant where instead of enjoying the company, everybody is looking down at their phone. So I think digital technology is partially to blame because it gives us a little hit of dopamine every time we search for something or we get a notification. There's a possibility that it could be something great, right? Whereas if you're with a person, you might say, well, I know what to expect there. I'm not gonna get any surprises. The other reason is that it's just so much, I guess, easier. It's like junk food. You can spend half a day shopping, chopping and cooking and preparing a wonderful meal and enjoy it with a lot of friends. Or you can just go to a snack bar, a luncheonette, and buy junk food, and it will take you probably 5 to 10 minutes and you'll get the same amount of calories. If you're only interested in the calories, there's no difference. If you're interested in the experience and what it does to you overall in the long run, then really you're going to go for the more complex experience. And I just find it paradoxical that there's a huge resurgence in interest in kind of traditional ways of cooking, traditional ways of brewing beer, making liquor, people are knitting their own sweaters, they're making their own pickles. All of this is happening with a kind of love affair with the past, except for the way people used to interact.